Well, Jen, New York officials gave a lot of credit to law enforcement in Massachusetts for stopping the bombers before they got too far. Credit also goes to the man who the brothers are accused of carjacking.
New York Mayor Michael Bloomberg says they learned about the alleged plot less than 24 hours ago.
Last night we were informed by the FBI that the surviving attacker revealed that New York City was next on their list of targets.
At a news conference this afternoon, the mayor and police commissioner Raymond Kelly said the decision to bomb New York City was apparently spontaneous.
We learned through the Joint Terrorist Task Force that the Boston Marathon bombers had planned to travel to Manhattan to detonate their remaining bombs in Times Square.
The brothers were planning to get to Times Square by driving the SUV they had hijacked. The explosives they still had included a pressure cooker bomb and 5 pipe bombs. But then their plan fell apart.
When they realized that the vehicle that they hijacked was low on gas and ordered the driver to stop at a nearby gas station, the driver used the opportunity to escape and call the police. That eventually led to the shootout in Watertown, where the older brother was killed in an exchange of gunfire with the police.
New York's mayor says even if they had made it to Times Square, they would have been met with high security.
If, God forbid, they had arrived in New York City and gone to Times Square, one thing for sure, they would have seen an enormous police presence. But they would not have seen extensive networks of cameras that are part of our security initiative and which can help police identify suspicious movements such as packages left unattended on the streets.
Now, the carjacking victim talked only to News 9 earlier this week, saying he thought the brothers would kill him, so he knew he had to escape whenever he got the chance. Investigators are now also looking into trips that the younger Tsarnaev brother took to New York City last year. In the studio, Shelley Walker, WMUR News 9.